This time I start the portrait with a very accurate drawing. I want to bet on a complete likeness because it's my granddaughter. She poses for me in a typical Madrid costume, dressed as a chulapa. The chulapa is a person of the popular classes of the late 19th century in Madrid. Madrileños may dress up like that during the festivities of San Isidro. It also includes a white headscarf, but I want to show in this demonstration how to paint the specifics of blonde, straight hair, so without the white headscarf. I paint on heavy-duty linen. And I applied 3 layers of gesso. I make the underpainting in acrylics, burnt sienna mainly in the face and some in the dress, and magenta for the rest of the painting. There are 3 main reasons for an underpainting. First, to nail down the main features of the model. Secondly, as an indication for the shadows on the face. But take a close look, I don't paint these shadows with outlines. That's important because these lines may show up through the oil paint later. I elaborate the face schematically but very accurately, especially around the eyes and the mouth. Should I get lost when painting in oil paint, then I can easily find the underpainting by wiping off the top coat of the paint. Another thing is, if you paint your underpainting in acrylics, it works as a fixative also for your drawing. Difficulties applying acrylic paint to the ground. If it's too greasy, it rejects the water-based paint. You can solve that easily by mixing oxgel. Your art supplier will sell that, or perhaps at the drugstore around the corner. But ordinary hand soap can satisfy also. A different color magenta for the sofa, her dress and the background. Almost always when I plan to make larger areas blue, I put this cool red shade underneath. This makes the final blue color in oil paint richer in quality. I often do that when I have to paint, for instance, a blue sky in a landscape. I give you a glimpse into my studio when I'm filming. A tangle of cables, lamps and cameras, a lot to keep an eye on, and sometimes it's difficult to make a good painting at the same time. Next week I will publish the final art of this portrait, so see you next week.